know, me and Kyle have been racing together since we were on 65, so, you know, Loretta Lynn's and Ponca City.
Can't really say I don't like anything about him. You know, I know him, you know, I say hi and, you know, talk a little bit. You know, I'm not best friends with him.
Pretty cool, you know, growing up and being able to race with each other through, you know, the pro ranks and everything else.
Here I have the points lead now, so I'm just going to, you know, ride smart and try to get through this week.
You know, second place isn't what I wanted, but it was better than third or last, so.
Of all the guys to get beat by, you know, he's probably the one I would want to. You know, he rides awesome.
May the best man win, that's all I got to say.
Welcome to round 8 of the 2006 Canadian Motocross Championships. This is the Sandalie MX Park in Richmond, Ontario, just outside of the nation's capital in Ottawa. Mark Travers and Brian Koster on the track. And Brian, the sun is shining. It's MX2 East Championship Day. What more could a guy ask for?
Not a lot, man. This is a new track for 06. It's long, it's fast, lots of flow, deep sand. And yes, round 4, the final round for MX2 East Championship. Kyle Chisholm has the upper hand coming in. Willard's there a few points back. This is motocross, anything can happen. A lot of unfinished business to see who rounds out that podium. I tell you what, it's gonna be fast. It's gonna be a tsunami out here.
Tsunami. And in MX1, Klatt's only 9 points ahead of Wah. The battles are gonna be on the track. It's gonna be intense. Fabs, bring in the sails, buddy. We're about to get covered in sand.
To the leaderboard after 3 of 4 rounds. Chisholm, a full 25 points on Willard. But how about gold, a medallion for top Canadian. Cook in there and Genereux rounds it out.
Let's get to MX1. Klatt and Wah, only 9 points separating those two bangers. Morgan is looking great in third, but a bunch of Canadians down to 8, and Gavin Graysick in 9th.
All right, race fans, that is the kind of stuff we are going to see all day long here at Sandalie for round 8 of the CMRC Nationals. This place is awesome. I've been racing it for years, and it's so good to see a national here. Now let's get right to the track. Beautiful sand layout, but underneath, it's got a little bit of Deschambault with some clay, some ruts going down the straightaways. Guys' bikes are going to be dancing all day long going around. But on the outsides, as that dirt gets pushed out, soft, big, Gopher Dune-style kind of berms. You can just rail those things. You're going to be watching guys laying the bars down, having lots of fun. The next thing they've changed here, a few big jumps from our local races. They've had a jump on the backside. Now the faces of these things are getting rutted out. They get the bumps in them because it is the sand. It starts to wear down. So as the day goes on, keep an eye on those because this guy's going to be going all over the place. But I'll tell you what, lots of fun air. The last thing you want to get into here, long ruts and clay in the dirt. Going around the finish line turns, it's an off-camera kind of thing. Long ruts, guys are staying in. The guys that are popping out, bikes are skidding all over the place. Keep it on your toes. And the one thing you got to remember here at Sandalie is patience. It's kind of one line, so the guys that can chill out and pick their spots to pass are the guys that are going to come in top here at Sandalie.
Let's get out onto the track with Notorious G in the Scott USA helmet cam.
Thanks, Travis. Here's Goldie coming out of the back section of Riser. Love this shoot into a 180. We're going to get some big braking bumps here. You see how big the berm's forming on the outside? Nice and smooth here. Sunday morning, Goldie on the gas. A little jump and then like a ski jump here. The guys that really want to make a pass are flying 10 to 12 feet further than their competition. Look how wide the Sandalie track is. Just love it. Goldie makes a pass on the inside there in another gear on another rider out there into a big roller section. You can see Ryan nice and smooth here, landing it just beautifully, whizzing by another rider into a true bona fide sweeper. And this is really hard underneath. You get ledgy berms, really tricky, kind of flat tracking through there. Ryan opts for a tear-off removal at the checkered flag tower. Now, pin it. You can see some of the bumps already starting to form. Big braking bumps here, and Goldie, typical Sandmaster, inside, outside, missing those bumps. Love this tabletop. You turn in midair, kind of scrub, come in here, lean it over, and get on the gas. See, Goldie goes to the outside, kind of turns in. That's a double, triple option. Lots of those out on the Sandalie track. Little mound in the corner like that. Get down in here, suspension compresses, traction optimum into this corner here. You can see the width up on the high bank or the inside. The rider that keeps his eye open and picks those smooth lines is gonna be a winner. Here we go, another double triple option. The 250Fs doubling. It's a bit of a big gap for the smaller motorcycles. The big MX-1 boys easily triple into the backwoods section. Open season on the gas, Travers. I love MX-101.
Woo! What a great job from Fabulous. How about a little Yamaha Sand Nami? Some of the action still to come.
Turned some heads out in the West Coast riding the 450 in the MX-1 class, but really you're hired for the MX-2 class. Did really well last weekend too in Moncton.
You know, like I said, every race is kind of like a learning experience for me. I've been racing for long, but I've only been racing for so short. So yeah, last weekend was real good. We got 8th overall, and out West was just great for my confidence, I think, and my strength more than anything. Getting back on the 250F really makes it feel a little easier, you know, with a little bit shorter motos and the lighter bike. It just, I feel that much stronger the whole time.
All right, let's get things started here at the Sandalie MX-101 Park. This first MX-2 moto will be brought to you by No Fear Motocross Apparel. Good shot of the boys on the line in a blue sky. Rockin' Randy Hall with the 30F Fabulous, and we are ready to go.
Oh, I just love this part of the day. I can see the riders going through their rituals, slipping it into gear here with the 5-second board up and a long, safe start, and it is groomed perfectly. Drive!
The sand is so deep through here. Look at the bikes rocking back and forth. Coming to the first corner, who's gonna get that Royal Distributing hole shut? And it is Ian Hayden with a great start.
On that Royal Distributing KTM, we just interviewed him, fueled his fire, and he goes out, nails the whole
shot. Oh,
GG boy down, Ryan Gold with that points battle with Medallia down. And look, Medallia's got a good start in the top five.
Riders sailing over the tunnel jump, Brian off to the right. Oh, big carnage here in the early start. Looks like Chamberlain.
Matt Barnes got hung up and caused a chain reaction. Oh, Tim Trombley just goes down. One rider makes a little bit of a slowdown, and look what happens. Carnage.
Medallia on the inside takes care of 695. That's Ritter, but a great start for Evano. And we have Hayden in the lead with Chisholm in second place.
See Evano slide through there big time in fourth. He is hanging it out right now, and he's got the bit between his teeth on that Yamaha.
Number 170, Craig Dubé in third place. Great start for that Northeastern American as they come through this back section, Brian. Wide open, and look at how wide the track is.
You can see Chisholm take a peek back. He wants to know where his competition. At. There's Medallia sitting about fifth, and Ben Ritter right there. Adam Deacon on the LTL Expedited Air two-wheel Honda with a great start, as well as Snellgrove and Trevor Hall's in the mix.
Another awesome start for number 62, Ian Hayden. There goes Chisholm. Oh my goodness, the speed they're carrying through here. And there is number one, Michael Willard, who is on a tear, and he's got Dubé in his sights.
You know, Willard doesn't like the sand, that's what he says, but he always rides so well in it. Oh, guys, over the bars off the finish line jump. And the rest of the pack funnels through. Hey, Neil Farlow got a good start as well in this moto, number 511 on the Katoom.
Let's watch the lines for Chisholm as they come to this huge banking corner on the Kawasaki. Oh, I love that carrying speed for Chisholm on the outside. He definitely has Hayden in his sights.
Chisholm, a Florida sand specialist, though this sand is very hard underneath. It's not quite like that bottomless deep sand, let's say, Gopher Dunes or the sand.
Hayden
throws away the lead, goes over the berm. See the size of that berm? He's struggling to get the bike up right now. Come on, Ian. We'll see if he keeps the motor running. Three-pack of KTM's Pro-Am rider Austin King in front of Barnes and Montes. And here comes Galdi charging through the pack on a tear. Travers, he's passed a ton of guys. So far, his lap times are incredible.
Look at the speed that Chisholm is carrying right now. He has the lead. Evano in second. But Willard is hot on his heels, Brian. You talked about Willard not liking the sand. Look at him go. Oh, no. Number 198, Jenneroux down over that combination jump you talked about in the middle.
It just shows you how fast you can do a face plant out here. Three Americans up front right now setting the pace. Willard, the bit between his teeth. He's got Avenue right there in his sights through the back section. Love this part of the track.
Whoa.
Medallia and Dubé raging a war. They've been interchanging that fifth position several times so far.
See how wide the track is, boy, with that little crisscross in the back section. Like the way Tyler Medaglia rides this track. Look at Pierce Chamberlain on the inside of Deacon. Adam Deacon, first year in the pros. That kid has got something going on.
Absolutely. Like to see that kind of battling gaining experience. Chamberlain riding well, but number 22, Jay Burke on the Toyota Yamaha, having problems here in the first MX-2 moto. He is riding four motos today in two
classes.
Look
at the speed they're carrying through this section, Brian. Bonsai, full berserker for Willard on the outside. Does he have him with the crisscross? Goes inside on Avenue. It was only a matter of time, although I love the way that Avenue was riding out here. Typical Avenue, Bonsai on the pipe.
Definitely. And you know, Willard's been using that outside line all weekend, and it's working for him with the crisscross. And you can see how rough it was coming in there. This track's starting to get churned up. Hayden now back on the pipe. He's got his quasi teammate, Johnny Montez, on that Stone Ridge Shoes KTM right there. He's showing Hayden the wheel, Travs.
Hayden, a great starter, very fast, Brian, but he has to get more aggressive on the track. There it is right there, Montez on the inside.
What a great pass for Montez. You can see him lean back just to get that back wheel to bite in on the sand. Talk about on a mission right now. Chisholm is all about it, pulling a gap. Pierce Chamberlain in the mix again. Look at the aggression on Tremblay, number 50 on that Yamaha. Remember Tremblay from a few years ago? Travs, look at him on the outside, and look at that. That is visions of Jean-Sébastien Roy. You know, he's a French-Canadian rider. He's been following Roy for years, modeling himself after the champ. I love it.
Tremblay using the width of the track, Ryan. That's the one thing about this track. It is wide. You can go inside and outside. Galdi now moving up on Hayden.
Look,
we talked about Hayden's
choice.
Defense. Hayden has got to get more aggressive because Galdi is super wise at choosing lines.
He certainly is the old owl of the sand, and you can see it right there in front of us. Medallia now, he's looking for some smooth ways around. You can see the jump face is starting to run up. He's sitting pretty in fourth. Galdi, though, right now, right up outside of the top 10, and he is charging hard on the rest of the field right now.
Remember, Galdi went down in the first quarter, Brian. He was in last place. 447, Evenot is off the track. Brian, checking the Kickstarter, we might have a Caesar.
Yeah, that's right. He's checking the compression there. That is Evenot's mechanic. Back to Barnes and Montez. Galdi right there. Montez has a peek back. Look at Galdi. He loves that line. That's where he made the move earlier on Hayden. Riding really smoothly. This moto's starting to wind down. Looks like Montez and Barnes in trouble.
How about Tyler Medallia right now in third place? Home crowd loving this action. Galdi coming up off the tabletop, has the inside line on Montez and moves into 10th. A last lap pass for Galdi. Great drive.
And you see Galdi did not hit one bump there. Just blew by Montez there. What a great setup pass. And the pass has a lot to do with the setup and the planning on where you get on the throttle. Here comes our winner right now. Kyle Chisholm takes it, Travs.
He will clinch the championship with that win, Brian.
First moto results. Chisholm with a championship medallia. Gaps, Galdi, Doobie has a good ride, as does Tremblay, Chamberlain, Ritter, Deacon in there. Barnes in ninth.
Okay, Kyle Chisholm, I'm seeing number ones all over the place, buddy. A big win here in the first moto and an unofficial clinching of the championship. Congratulations.
Thanks. Feels awesome. Last year, at this time, kind of stoked for me. Crowds were crazy. I don't even know what to say. I'm so happy. Glad everyone could be here. My mom didn't make it, but it's awesome. The team did an awesome job. My Hannah Braun, my family, my girlfriend came out for this one, and it's awesome.
Number 57, Tyler Medallia picks up a gift from Evenot in this first moto. Third spot on the podium. Tyler, you rode great in that moto, hung in there in fourth, and then picked up that gift. How are you doing?
I'm doing really good. You know, it's so good to do it in front of my home crowd and everything. And I got a bit of good luck from Evenot, and because I made a mistake, I was kind of gaining on him a bit there during the moto, and then I made a mistake up on the tabletop, lost some time, and then I don't even know what happened. I guess he pulled off or something. So no, I'm just still so happy.
Wow, what a great moto and a great track. Stick around, the MX1 boys. There's Dowdy and Treadwell ready to serve it up.
Big switch this weekend, Mason Phillips on the 228 over to the Richmond Kawasaki and bringing back the always lovable Mr. Mike Treadwell, number 10. Great race going on here, Stanley. Like, keep an eye on the 10, the 228 on that Cowie. These guys are going to be serving it up with those guys out of the top 10 like Lange, Fasciotti, Willard, Graysick. These guys are going to be mixing it up. So top 10 positions are real key here with two rounds remaining in the National Series.
How about the training program? Everyone knows the Iron Mike Treadwell. The name has been kind of a legend up here for many years. So how's the iron training program coming along?
Well, to tell you the truth, what I do is when I'm going to pass somebody, I punch him in the third rib. He pushes all the bile out of the body, and he says, oh, my insides are bleeding. And I say, I don't know whether I'm ecstatic or ludicrous. Hey, ludicrous.
So that's still
that's
working
a pretty
out
big
good
word.
For you?
All the big boys are on the line, Brian, and this first MX1 moto will be brought to you by MX Performance Magazine, a beautiful facility here at Sandalie MX Park. The MX101 boys are serving it up.
I'll say this is a bona fide national circuit. First time ever here, and Kevin Tyler and his crew from MX101 have done a ton of work on this facility to bring it up to spec.
Oh, gate goes down, Brian. Someone gets hung up. Let's go to that first corner. Jean-Sébastien with a great start. Dusty Clad on the inside. He gets that Royal Distributing hush hat.
How about Dowdy and his teammate Northrop? Blair Morgan right in there. Doobie's in there.
Oh,
and Kyle Dean with a good start.
Oh, Treadwell's down. We've got carnage in the first corner, Brian. He's holding his hand. Not sure what is going on as the boys funnel over the tunnel. I love the way they fly through that jump. Kyle Beaton with a great start. You're right, a pair of Susies up there. Blair Morgan, Marco Dubé, and number 228, Phillips.
Kyle Beaton, the agitator, with a great start, makes a move on Morgan. That is for fifth up the inside, and I think he's got him. But how about Klatt, how quickly he moved into the lead there. I thought Waugh had the whole shot, and Klatt just snuck right in.
You know Klatt wants to get he just roosted the chip huge over that jump. John Sebastian Waugh still in tow right now. Brian, you do not want to follow in this track, or you're going to be eating sand all day long.
Just another day at the office for John Sebastian Waugh. NorCal over jumps if it takes a bounce. Beaten right on the money on his triple. Sneaks right up the inside. Drag racer Yamaha to Suzuki. We'll see who has the advantage. There's Klatt, and look how rough it's getting. This morning, that was smooth.
Kyle Beaton on the outside didn't get the measure on NorCal. I love the way, he turns his head. A little bit of water there, Brian. Kyle Beaton is so fast off the start. He's got to get his game together from the beginning of the moto to the end.
True that. Ultra aggressive rider. You can see Morgan taking his time, getting sorted out like Goldie said earlier. Replay at the start. Here comes Davey Fraser, saw Scotty Mademan's front wheel right out from under him. Then Treadwell goes down, just minding his own business. Travs and a soil sample.
That's a racing incident though. Brian Fraser was carrying a lot of speed, kind of squared up that corner. And you're right, it looks like Treadwell got his hand tucked down the inside of Mademan's bike as they were going down. Not looking too good right now. Oh my goodness, tough break for Mike Treadwell. As we get back to our leaders, there's Nine Klatt and Waugh in second place. Oh, Brian carrying so much speed through here. It is getting rough.
Waugh looks just beautiful right now on the motorcycle. Five-time Canadian champ. Klatt pulling out a couple seconds, but Waugh keeping him honest right now for sure. Number 30, Chad Charbonneau's been looking strong all weekend, as has number 19, Ryan Lockhart. They're battling right now, Travs, for about sixth place.
You know how comfortable Charbonneau is in the sand. Blair Morgan now starting to pick his way up. Looks like he's got number 25, the original, in his sights.
Absolutely, this is the back section. I love these flat corners. That's Simon Holman's coming in a gear high, looking very threatening. Oh, and look at Klatt control the motorcycle and those braking bumps. About 3 seconds now on John Sebastian Waugh. And this track getting rougher and rougher every lap.
Waugh, I think, for that inside line, Brian. A little bit of a slide. Look at Morgan on the outside of NorCal through the FMF off camber.
These long motos, Morgan, very patient today, and it's working for him. He's up to fifth place right now, slowly picking his way to the front of the pack, and love and clap. Blair Morgan with a real creative, smooth line on the outside, puts Beaton back to fifth, puts himself into fourth, and look at Beaton looking for the smooth lines, opposite sides of the track. With sand, it's always inside, outside. Now, number 24, Marco Dubé, Travs, picking up on NorCal.
The riders talk about wide tracks and why they like them. It's obvious, Brian. It gives them options. Look at Dusty Klatt. He has opened up the gap on John Sebastian Waugh, but I cannot believe the speed they're carrying out here. This is by far the fastest track I've seen so far.
Just love the flow also. This track flows beautifully. The riders just get into the zone and into a rhythm. Nice seat bounce, triple there for Beaton, but NorCal works his way past. These two have been cat and mouse this whole moto. This is bar to bar for fifth place. Drag racing through the rocker rollers into the big Cowie Bay corner. And with the sand, you can really change trajectory. So much easier than a hard pack track.
Number 161, the Junkyard Dog, currently in third place right now. Brian, we'll have to look for Blair Morgan to see where he is. Look at Simon Holmans going outside to inside and making the pass on Kyle Beaton.
And experience towards this part of the moto and the strength that Simon Holmans possesses. It's not a surprise that he's taken that position from young Kyle Beaton, but Beaton's day will come, Travs.
How about cousin Milos, Milo Christie on the inside of Davey Fraser for 14th. Both of those young privateers looking good right now. Blair Morgan has made up a lot of ground on John Dowd. I love that kind of stuff. Now the Mez is going inside on the Salty Dog.
You know, Chuck Mesley, number 45 on that machine bike, didn't get the greatest start. This is the battle for 10th. He's caught up a lot. He's just past Kyle Beaton, so Beaton getting a little flustered here as the moto winds down.
Junkyard Dog, number 161, John Dowd in third place through this ultra-fast, whooped-out sand section. Here comes Morgan. You want to talk about patience, Brian. He has taken his time and made his way up on third place. I'm loving what I've seen from Morgan today.
I can't believe he's caught up to the Junkyard Dog. Dowdy, known as a New England sand specialist, he rocks. He's the king of Subway. And there's does the seat bounce triple for Blair Morgan. Puts himself right on the inside. Dowdy knows he's there. He can hear him and see him from Riffrey. And there's Morgan just bouncing across the track. Dowdy's just going, man, these Canadians are fast.
Dowdy finished sixth at Southwick this year, Brian. Let's talk about Blair Morgan and the speed he is carrying right now in the series. Johnny Dowd is a sand legend, and Morgan just took him to task.
Morgan, a bona fide world action sports icon out here mixing it up with one of the best sand riders in the world.
Number 22, Johnny. Oh, he gets it all wrong, Brian. Oh. A little bit of a low slide. It can happen any time, and he went down hard on his hip.
Oh, that is a very fast part of this track. Hits that bounce, gets light. They float all the way down. Right here, his back end gets kicked out. His front end nice down, lands right on his hip. And I tell you, the ground was shaking right to the pits from that. And oh yeah, he is holding that left hip.
He looked like he was doing it all right, coming over top of that jump. Dusty Cloud with a seat bouncer into that whooped out sand section. Where the heck is Wah? There he is, oh my, he's right behind him. The gap is closing.
And I just love the width and the line choices out here. Wah is very tenacious, and he's not giving up. He's looking ahead, and he's charging in. He's actually reeling Dusty in a little right now. And there's the battle for third. Uh-oh, Kawasaki demons for Mason Phillips.
Looks like a little bit of clutch work on the side, Brian, and it was smoking. Last lap, Brian, look at the gap. It is closed down to inside of a second. Wah is on the pipe. We had word that Klatt went down in the back section. Wah is on the gas.
That is what happened, and that's why Wah's right there. To our FMF Feel the Power Action Cam, and Dowdy rolling around at speed behind Morgan. Oh, beaten with a problem. Now look at the roost being generated by Dusty Klatt. Jean-Sebastian Wah, the model of consistency, right on his back fender. Out jumping Klatt, landing on the downside of those braking bumps. Ay, 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 what's going on here?
You can see Klatt using all of the track, getting into that dusty part out there, Brian, and causing a huge havoc of roost. Look at Klatt on the inside, Wah on the outside. Oh, and did you see how smooth Klatt was through there? And the gap opens up, coming into the final corner.
One more corner, barring disaster, Klatt will take it, but you know, I love to see the champ. Jersey untucked, that is his trademark. Oh, second place, Jean-Sebastian Wah. Klatt pulls it out from a crash. What a thrilling moto.
The two best riders in the country. Freestyle up next. Oh, what a great day we have here for motocross racing at the Sandalie Park, just outside of the nation's capital in Ottawa. Let's get to that leaderboard, first MX1 moto. Whoa, what a battle between Klatt and Wah. We've got Morgan in third place, Dowdy in fourth. I love Duvet in seventh, Lockhart looking good in ninth, and Johnson in tenth.
Morton, Manitoba was pretty good, but I'll tell you what, round eight, Sandalie just saw the number nine, Dusty Klatt and Chasar have a battle like no other. Dusty, you made that one really difficult on yourself, crashing halfway, and JSR kept you honest right to the checker flag.
Yeah, you know, I made that bob there, you know, my suspension was kind of bucking me out there, and I needed to make some changes before the second moto and try to go from there, but after I fell up, I was holding my clutch, and when I was on the ground, I got up, and it was, my play was going right into my bar, so I, you know, I had to fool around with that for the first lap there, and, you know, it just... I mean, you know, kind of took a bit out of me, and JSR was closing in, so you know, I just try to keep my head straight and try to make the best of it and take the win. But that was good.
The domination of Blackfoot continues. Blair Morgan, number seven, taking third. Blair, an unbelievable ride, man. You and Dowdy went at it all moto. You had to work your butt off to get into third, and you hung on to it to the finish.
Yeah, you know, I just had a decent start and just riding really tight. I didn't know what my problem was. I was just getting kind of arm pump and stuff and tried to relax a little bit. And yeah, just wanted to get down. You know, I wanted to be 1-2-3 for Honda Blackfoot. So yeah, it feels good to, he was on me the last like six laps. So it's good to hold off John Dowd in the sand.
Time to go big time freestyle style. Idle Sons are back with us and the track is Maggots.
I'll admit I'm-
You've got to go fast. You've got to lay it on the line. You've got to hang it out. But then again, you've got to finish and not crash. I mean, you're always right on that fine envelope of disaster or glory.
That's exactly true. And the MX2 classes more emphasize that than the MX1 class, just because the little bikes, yeah. You always got to be on it, because there's a jump coming up that you might just be able to clear, and you've always got to be on it. So I think that's, you know, maybe after I hurt my knee last year, maybe I just kind of lost that edge, you know, that ride on the edge. I'm kind of don't want to do it. So maybe I just got to get past that point, you know.
Let's get ready to bang some bars, MX2 style, coming up. All hometown hero number 57, Tyler Medaglia, on the line, ready to do battle. Second MX2 moto here from Sandalie MX Park. And this one was brought to you by Answer Racing. Brian, Bluebird Skies. Oh, those are the two best riders in this class.
And they're lined up right on the inside. Seems like there's the best traction there, and it is the shortest distance to the first turn. We've got a great crowd out here to witness this live here today. Beautiful day. Randy Hall goes to five. Travs, who's going to get that Royal Distributing hole? Shit!
Oh, the gate is down, Brian, funneling through that loose sand. Willard on the inside. Hayden looking good. We are going to give that Royal Distributing hole shot to number one, Michael Willard.
Can you believe Hayden almost got two hole shots, man? That kid is wicked off the start. Medaglia third. Great start for him. Suzuki Pierce Chamberlain right in the mix as well. Great to see that Ocean Transport bike up front.
Another good start for Cowie, 695. That's Ritter. That's two good starts for him. The field starting to funnel through here. Brian, let's get some lines. Montez looking good. Barnsey on the outside. And Tyler Medaglia, you're right, with a great start. Look at Ritter on the inside. I love the options again.
Ben Ritter. Oh my goodness. Evenepoel came into gear high and just tagged the back end of Montez and then got run over by Ryan Gold.
Oh, that one had to hurt.
That hurt right in the pelvis area in his leg. But it's Willard out front with the Royal Distributing hole shot. Hayden right there. And now Chisholm moves into second place with a heads-up move and just a berm shot away from first.
I love the way he blocked Hayden's line coming to that corner and went high on the berm, carrying speed
through that back wheel.
Let's get to the crash.
There it is. Montez knifes in on Evenepoel. Evenepoel's got nowhere to go, and then Galdi with nowhere to go again runs right over Evenepoel. Galdi, an innocent bystander there. That's a typical racing incident.
Oh, that is not the place you want to go down as we get back to our leaders. About a second and a half, Pico in third. There is Hayden, and look at Montez on the outside, Brian. I love those lines.
Using the Willard line all around, missing the bumps. Whoa. Willard right now just in attack mode. Pulling a gap right now on Chisholm. Chisholm, the Florida Sand Specialist, though, with his head up, looking ahead, steering the motorcycle with the legs and the inner thighs. They come into this corner, third gear, just pinned on these bikes. They don't even downshift here. They carry third, work the clutch a bit as we get back to 408 Paul Lamb, and you can see the bumps, trash forming all over this racetrack.
Sand whoops, Brian, but remembers that clay base underneath, so it's not going to open up like Gopher Dunes. Tyler Medaglia's got some lines, and he has one on the inside of Ian Hayden. Oh, the blocker. I love that stuff. Very aggressive for number 57, Tyler Medaglia.
Medaglia, local boy, knows the sand, so he kind of knows how the bike's going to react. It's going to slide to a point, hit the berm, and hook up. And he's working that slide and hook up to his advantage.
Oh, Brian, there's 447. Evenepoel, very ginger, getting off the track. He does not look good. He is one tough hombre, but his podium hopes have gone out the window today as we get back to our leaders. Number one, Michael Williams. Oh, Chisholm with the moment, and he is off the track.
Chisholm, very aggressive, closed the gap a bit, but got his one foot, tore off the peg, went over the berm. He's going to have to regroup and remount his charge.
Oh, we got a rider down.
That's Chamberlain.
It is. You're right.
Oh, my God.
29, Pierce Chamberlain.
Third place rider down. Keeps it going. Only loses one position. Really good for him. Back to Hayden. He's sitting fifth right now, and we've got Barnes right there in sixth.
Another great battle for the lead, Brian, between Willard and Chisholm. And you know, Chisholm does not even have to ride this moto. He has already clinched the championship.
True that. Love this part of the track, man. The black soil kind of in the shaded areas. They've done a masterful job of watering here. Here is the battle for 10th. A pair of privateers. That is Kevin Gregoire on the Yamaha and Craig Doobie, New England Sand Specialist, on the Cowie. Travs, great shot of that Scott USA lockoff can.
As they come into that wide switchback section that takes them into the backwoods, Doobie with that inside line. Love the way Gregoire's carrying speed.
Doobie with his head up, just crisscrossing, looking for any way around. Back back to the pressure Ian Hayden is under right now. Big time. Montez got him. First of all, Montez gets sucked out in that soft stuff. And on these 250F, it just saps the power as Tremblay moves in.
Look at the battle for the lead, Brian. It is on fire right now. About 1.5 to 2 seconds. There's number 57, Tyler Medaglia, comfortable in third, all alone riding the track by himself.
Is he ever? Right now, he's got to rely on his mechanic to tell him what is up. Back to some more battling. Montez in the mix, big time, taking care of Ritter. That puts him into eighth place. Montez has to get a little more aggressive, I think, coming into the corners, because once he's in the corners, man, he runs with the best of them.
MX2 East and West, a great place for young privateer Americans and Canadians to come up and show the wares. Ritter's a prime example as we see our leaders funneling through that back section. There's Ritter again, and another privateer, Doobie, on the inside. This track is wide, Brian. Doobie has got lines out here. I love that kid.
Kawasaki's got to be stoked to have these privateers on their motorcycles showing off what those Kawasaki's
Brian,
can do.
Brian.
Oh! Big trouble. It is a good thing he clinched that championship early by a scant 3 points, because he is DNFing this motor right now. He is stopped on the side of the track. He doesn't know what's up. Look how tricked that bike is, too. The Pro Circuit forks, the gold nitrate coating. Oh, my God, that bike is sweet.
Off to the side, Chisholm with some issues. Look at the way that Tim Tremblay held his line through the soft stuff. Does he have Barnes on the outside? Brian, tight corner, and then it opens up. You got inside, you got outside. Take your pick.
You know, the CMRC this year, the tracks are spectacular. We've had 8 rounds with no rain. What a great year so far. Medaglia, home crowd, in second place now with Chisholm out. This is enormous for him. And with his battle with Galdi, he is in prime spot to be top Canadian.
You better believe in Medaglia in second place. Barnes, and now we've got Tim Tremblay up on Barnes as they get through that eight pack, as they call it here. Right, look at the options. Tim Tremblay is a big man on that little motorcycle. He knows how to carry speed.
Just soak those bumps up like they're not even there. But I got to touch on Galdi. He is out. We just got a report that his brake pedal got wrapped right around the foot peg when he contacted Evenot. So Galdi is out of this moto completely. Just threw all those points away. Medaglia poised for top Canadian.
Number one, Michael Willard, all alone now in first place. The championship is out. He will finish in second place as we sit right now. Oh, my. Tim Tremblay bouncing all over the place as he passes number 29, Pierce Chamberlain, to move into third place.
It takes a lot of strength to soak up those big G-outs. Tremblay gets the job done.
Brian, look at this. Chisholm's back on the track, and he's tucked right in behind Willard a couple laps down.
That's funny. He's just pulled on the track right behind our leader. That has got to be playing mind games on Willard right now, but he knows he's a few laps out of it.
Doobie now moving up on Chamberlain. That'll be for fourth spot if he can make that happen. Now Willard looking back. Is he giving him the wave?
Yeah,
Chisholm saying no, just go for it.
Willard's not comfortable having him following him around. Now they're just putting around there.
I don't think Chisholm wants to push him off. I think they want to have a little fun out there. The battle for fourth is still intense. Doobie working up on Chamberlain, and I think I saw Barnes moving up to make it a three-pack.
There's battles throughout this pack right now. Doobie showing Chamberlain a wheel. Hits that bump, and Chamberlain's safe for now. But for how long? Look at these square-edge braking bumps. And that's the thing with this hard base, really square-edge. So possibly rougher on the ride than, say, a deep flowing sand track.
Definitely the best race I've seen Chamberlain run so far. Willard rounding that off camber, the FMF off camber, coming to his final approach here, Brian. He's going to win this moto, and he's got Chisholm right behind. There he is with the look, takes the checkered flag, and there is Chisholm. Some good camaraderie between these two guys.
Unbelievable 3-point difference. This could have been Willard's championship with Chisholm's DNF, but not to be. Tim Tremblay now, his first podium, takes third. And how about Montez and Chamberlain right down to the wire? And Chamberlain hangs on for fourth. To the leaderboard, Willard takes a Medaglia, and Tremblay have the ride of their lives. Montez moves up, Barnes slips back. Hovis has a great ride, as does Hayden and Gregoire.
Third place, MX2 East, number 26, Matt Barnes, ladies and gentlemen, Matt Barnes. Matt, I know that you missed third place position last year in the MX2 East, and I know that didn't sit well with you. You came back here with a mission to get on this podium. I know you wanted to win, but third place has to feel pretty good right now.
Yeah, it feels pretty good. You know, KTM gave me another shot for this year to come back up, and last year I got fifth, and this year I got third, and I'm pretty happy. And, you know, thanks to all the KTM guys, my mechanic Andreas, Andy White, Heidi, everybody that's been there for us. I mean, they've been great, and thanks to the fans, too, for coming out here and supporting us.
Ladies and gentlemen, winner of that last moto, number one, Michael Willard. Put it together, second place. There we go with the trophy, very nicely done. Now, it's been an interesting run for you, as we were saying, the eight motos. It's amazing how short it is, those highs and those lows. You have to be super consistent, don't you? And you know that from last year.
Yeah, you know, it's only four rounds, and you know, a DNF can put you out of the championship, maybe even out of the top 10. And you know, I just tried to stay consistent. I had a few get offs, and well, other than that, you know, I just wanted to win.
I'd like for all of you to welcome the new 2006 MX2 champion from the Richmond Motorsport Kawasaki team, Kyle Chisholm.
Yeah!
Congratulations, Kyle.
This year, I just want to come out and be consistent, like you said, and try to just win as many motos as I can, you know, one race at a time. And I did pretty good at that. We had some bad luck in this last moto, and I was kind of bummed we were having another good battle, you know, like we've had, you know, all year. And I tucked back in behind him. I didn't know he wanted to let me take the victory lap. I thought he was thinking I was messing with him, trying to take him out or something. I was just going to let him go. But he rode awesome, and, you know, he got this one, and I'm just really happy.
Congratulations to Richmond Kawasaki's Ron Bushy gets the Mechanics Wear Canada's Top Mechanic Award.
Banging bars from coast to coast, number 72, Milo Christie from Courtney, British Columbia, the home of Darcy Lange. Milo, some good rides. You had some bad luck with the bike theft, but the community came together and got you a bike.
Yeah, Gopher Dunes guys, they came together. Brett Lee from CMRC, they heard the news, and bam, bam, thank you, man. We got bikes by 11 o'clock that morning, so we just drove down there and made things happen.
Close and up front right there, number one, and the bottom of that thing says Blackfoot. When you hear Blackfoot in Canada, that is dominance. The one, the seven of Blair Morgan, the nine of Dusty Cloud, these guys have been on the podium almost every round all year long. The only thing that's problem with this is those guys are going for the title, Dusty and Wah. No one can get in the middle of them right now, so it's coming down to crunch time. One more update, Mike Treadwell in the first moto cross, the first turn. We're doing the finger thing. I can't do it. I think he's got lost one of his fingers. We're calling it mush. Tough break for Mike Treadwell. Glad we had him up here. We got to give some credit to these guys right there.
This is the final moto of the day. Brian, this last MX1 moto will be brought to you by Don Joy Knee Bracing. Good shot of the premier class on the line. Only a 12-point gap between Clad and Wah right now. This is a very important moto.
Yes, yes, and Don Joy is the choice of Simon Homans on his newly operated knee, so sponsors working good for some of the riders. The gate will go down here in 5 seconds. Travers, and this is an awesome start.
Rockin' Randy Hall, Frankenstein sideways, coming to that first corner, Brian. Look at that, Salty's got a nice start. We got Frazier on the side, but Wah is going to get that Royal Streaming Hold shot.
Watches Rooster cameraman and Dusty Clatt there getting by Lockhart. That was by a knobby. Lockhart gets a champ back over the tunnel jump. Loving it. Ryan Lockhart out front. That is two weekends in a row that he's led the MX1 class.
Number 9, Dusty Clatt in third. Very important right now between Clatt and Wah. You know how quick Clatt is up to start. Wah wants to hold him up. Oh, I love that line. Little blocker coming into that right-hander. Salty Dog has got some heavy pressure. Wah with a little slide out. Clatt on the outside, crossing over inside. Oh, Brian, a little freight train here over the tunnel.
Great experience for Ryan Lockhart. Imagine leading John Sebastian Wah and Dusty Clatt. This is huge for Lockhart, but it looks like Wah is making his move with that style, getting the traction down, gets by Lockhart, puts him into first, and Dusty Clatt lurking and looming right behind Lockhart.
Moving back to the battle for 6:25 NorCal and 4 KJ. Here we are in that back section, Brian. Wah leading. We've got Salty in second, and Dusty Clatt pressuring on the inside. Oh. Salty goes wide. Clatt on the inside. I think he has second.
See Dusty make that move. Lifted the front wheel up and brought it right over to cut to the inside. Misses all those bumps. He got a straight drive on Lockhart. I think he may have got him there outside of the trees, and yes, he did.
John Dowd not having a great start. He's in the top 10. Look at Dusty Clatt in second place. Again, using all of the track. Brian, that part of the track gets so whooped out as they break into that corner.
Just gets more whooped out with every lap, but it's beautiful out here. This starts to really separate the guys, and it is extremely tiring in this heat. Dubé now moves into eighth place on that 06 450 KTM.
Having a look at a pair of Yamis up here. Beaten with another good start and slides out. Brian, that guy cannot keep his bike on the track.
He's got to calm down a bit. He's going to be working with Todd, the trainer, for next year, so hopefully that works for him. And that is very hard rutted dirt. it is so easy to fall. And these guys are trying so hard to make an impression out here on the racetrack.
Galdi talked about the clay underneath the sand, Brian. You move that sand away and it's slippery clay. Blair Morgan on the outside through the eight pack. Does he have the dog? Yes, he does. Blair Morgan is so fast right now, Brian, and I like the fact that he got a good start in this moto.
He's just loving the Blackfoot bike, and you know they've got one of the best suspension guys in the business with Joe Skid, and that has got to do so much for a rider's confidence when you have a machine that works, and you can tell those Blackfoot Hondas are hooking up.
Some of the riders questioning that hay bale line out there, Brian, even though the track is really wide, they love to come in close. The Junkyard Dog going wide on Simon Holmans as he moves up a position.
Junkyard Dog tearing it up there, passing Holmans, puts him into sixth, so he is on his way to the podium right now. As the track gets rougher, I think that's where we're going to see Dowdy shine.
Both of our leaders, Brian, just floating over that title jump. Very smooth part of the track. Look at John Dowd with some huge drive off of that double, make it a triple. Number 25, NorCal, carrying speed. NorCal very impressive on the big bike, Brian.
I think if they weren't teammates, Dowdy would have made the pass there because he had the inside advantage, kind of backed off there. He makes a nice clean pass on NorCal, number 25 right here. And now another teammate right in front of him, and that's Ryan Lochner.
Three Suzukis up into the top five, Brian. Very impressive. We're missing KJ. We are missing Graysick, but these boys are holding up the honor.
Absolutely. You know, KJ's out there battling. He's got a bit of gear trouble. His shoulder pads kind of come apart. Blair Morgan massaging the track, Travis, as you like to say. And he's doing it in fine style.
A little seat bounce off of that, a little option package. Right back to number 19, Salty Dog. He's got the original right behind him. And look at Marco Dubé using all of the track.
And Holman's right there too, making things interesting. This is a wicked four-way battle for position. And NorCal with some funky English right there gets kind of cross-rutted. He'll regroup. The champ looks so fine right now. He's starting to pull a gaff on Dusty.
The middle part of this track, Brian, is the tightest part, and that's where we're seeing a lot of the passes. Oh, here comes Holmans in on the dock.
Nice!
Oh, my, very
nice!
Aggressive. You want to make a pass, Brian. That part of the track, a little one line. There are options on the outside, but it's way far on the outside.
All you young guys, watch out there. That is how you race motocross, and that is how you make a pass. Simon Holmans just sawing off the wheel on Lockhart. Nice, tight, clean racing. I love the contact.
Dowdy started in 10th. Now he's up to 4th. There goes Holmans and Dubé, 6-7. Johnson moving up. Salty Dog moving back. And Chuck Mesley with an inside line. Very tight back there, too,
Mesley moving forward. Lockhart kind of moving back a bit. I like Dubé there. His head right through the trees. Creative line choice. There's John Sebastian Waugh, the class of the field right now, lapping. And Tyler is one of the principals here at MX-101 and the key promoter of this whole event.
Dusty Klatsen comfortably in 2nd place with a nice seat bounce into that whooped out section, Brian. A great part of the track.
It sure is. I think Dusty's settling into 2nd now. Charbonneau, number 30 on that privateer Honda, coming up the inside of Chuck Mesley. And I believe he's by him, and that puts him right into the top 10.
Number 7, Blair Morgan, looking great through that FMF off camber. Number 228, Phillips, newly acquired for that Richmond Racing Kawasaki team, has Chad Charbonneau on the outside. Look at that square for Charbonneau as he's right on the heels of Phillips.
Charbonneau very aggressive, does the triple, and then makes the determined pass right there, filling Phillips with roost.
Number 19, Ryan Lockhart, moving back in the pack. There we go, number 111, Albuquerque. Keith finally getting into the mix, Brian.
Riding really well. I don't know if Lockhart's got a problem with the bike or what, or the heat's getting to him, but he is moving back. Now, Dowdy in 4th. Just like the first moto, we got Blackfoot 1-2-3, but it's JSR leading this time. And I think Klatt is slowing down a bit, settling into 2nd. He doesn't need to do anything stupid and jeopardize his points lead.
Both of these Blackfoot riders getting their last lap flags right now, Brian, as we get to number 1, John Sebastian Waugh on his final approach with a tear off through the FMF off camber. Brian coming in to take a win, closes the gap now to 9 points. This is exactly what he wants, and he gets the overall for the day.
And Waugh rode spectacularly well. Kudos to him. He is a picture-perfect rider to watch. Racing not done yet, though. These are teammates battling for 7th. It's Keith Johnson coming up on his teammate Northrup there. Look at Johnson's got that shoulder pad flapping around. And that's been the whole moto. And I tell you, that is going to bug the crap out of you. Every time you hit a bump, this thing's flapping around.
Pass of the year for KJ as he blows by number 25, NorCal. John Sebastian Waugh staking his claim here in the sand just outside of the nation's capital. Let's get to our leaderboard, 2nd MX1 Moto. Waugh with a great win in the overall. Let's go down to Holmans, Dubé, Johnson, Charbonneau, and Mesley rounding out the top 10.
Check that in right there, serving it up in the final Moto MX1 Styles JSR. Buddy, I told you I was going to take my shirt off and cheer you on. I apologize, I missed it, but it didn't look like you needed it.
No, but you're gonna have to do it, Walton. Yeah, thanks. Kyle, you know, good start. You know, the good start always make a difference. And just roll the moto. Just roll my moto. Choose looking for some good lines. The track is super, super rough. And you know, once again, CRF 450 Michelin tires. You know, it works really good out here.
All right, final standings for your MX2 East. You know your top three. Medallia, top Canadian. Evano down to fifth. Galdi in seventh. I like Chamberlain in sixth. Trombley and Montez rounding out the top 10.
Standings with the big boy. Clack comes in with a 9-point lead. Leaves with the same. Morgan has a great day. Holmans and Dume got some unfinished business, as does Lockhart and Johnson. Thanks for joining us here at Sandalie MX 101 Park. What a spectacular